Tonight in Chicago, the freeze of 79 takes us into the record books. A Gold Coast burglary ring is broken up, and the government declares a new war on cigarettes. Those stories and more coming up next.
Join us for Thursday's AM Chicago when four of Chicago's top models tell us of their glamorous lives before the cameras and the problems associated with being too beautiful. Robb?
Sandy, coming up on Friday, Lauren Bacall. Also, Amarillo Slim, the country's most successful poker player, is going to be giving us some gambling tips. Next week, Jim Belushi, Peter Graves, and Mr. and Mrs. Rifleman, Chuck Connors.
Join us for AM Chicago, 9 in the morning.
From grain-fed Western beef to plump frying chickens, when you take home A&P Famous Quality Meats, you take home meat that promises to cook as good as it looks. And that's an A&P promise.
Another reason why you'll do better at A&P.
U.S. government-inspected fresh spare ribs, 2-3-pound size, $1.19 a pound. Florida oranges, a 5-pound bag, just 99 cents. And A&P 1% milk, 1 gallon for $1.39 through Wednesday.
La Choy is Saturday supper, party snacks, servings for two, for family packs, an easy lunch for a hungry bunch. La Choy's great stuff for a midnight brunch. It's most anything you want it to be.
Even perks up a tired recipe.
To put it the way you may know best, here's our version of East meets West. La Choy makes Chinese food that swings American.
Coming up next, Chicago's number one news team. This is Eyewitness News at 10 for Wednesday, January 10th, reported tonight by Joel Daly and Terry Murphy. John Coleman with weather, Tim Weigel on sports.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Joel Daly.
And I'm Terry Murphy.
Here's the latest at 10 o'clock. Like it or not, we are 2 hours away from putting a new weather record in the books. We are living and shivering in what history will call the deep freeze of 79. John, I think this is one record you could have left out of the books.
Joel, the official record that we are working toward tonight is one for the most consecutive days below the zero mark. As of midnight, with the temperature below zero, we will surpass a record set way back before the turn of the century, when Chicago suffered through 12 consecutive days when the temperature dropped to zero or below. At 10 o'clock, we're officially four below at Airport Midway. And what that means is that if we just stay below zero for those two more hours, we'll tie the record. And here's the city that's shivering through the record. It wouldn't be so bad if we hadn't had a massive snow just before the temperature took the nosedive. Since the snow, it's been so cold that all efforts to unclog the streets of ice have really failed on the side streets through the city, and we're still pretty well tied up. In any case, I do see a warm-up coming, starting with a little snowstorm that will keep us above zero by the end of the week, and ending with a touch of a thaw next week. I'll have more on that later, Terry, but it is good news, isn't it?
I hope this doesn't signal the beginning of the ice age again, John.
Well, we're in it, aren't we, John?
Oh, this is it.
Yes.
You're an ice age redhead.
Meanwhile, Chicago police tonight recovered some cold cash, some hot goods, and three suspects along the city's Gold Coast. Fred Villanueva has that story.
Police think the three suspects are responsible for at least 31 apartment burglaries of Gold Coast high-rises. The burglaries took place within a mile radius from 800 North to 1300 North. All happened in the past month. Undercover police who had staked out this building at 1212 North Lakeshore Drive spotted two men trying to break into one of the rear entrances of the building. The two men were arrested on the spot and were found to be carrying screwdrivers and pry bars, the type of tools which were used in all of the break-ins. Two of the suspects are pictured here. 21-year-old John Baggett, the man with his face covered, is thought to be the ringleader. The other suspect in the blue sweater is 21-year-old Nathaniel Havis. Not pictured is a third suspect being held, 19-year-old Gregory Wallace. More than $30,000 in merchandise has been recovered. Police say they found jewelry, furs, radios, cameras, and television sets in the apartment of one of the suspects. All three men live in a building at 1159 North Cleveland. A fourth suspect is still being sought. This is Fred Villanueva, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
John Gacy has his day in court, and the legal maneuvering, which may go down in history, is underway. Jay Levine reports on the latest developments in this incredible case.
John Gacy's court appearance, the first time he's been seen in public since being brought here from Des Plaines almost 3 weeks ago, was held amidst the tightest security arrangements ever seen here at 26th in California. Tighter than the Harry Ailerman case, tighter than the Blackstone Rangers, tighter than the DeMaumaus.
Sir, County ID, put your briefcase up there.
Put your briefcase, please.
Put your briefcase up there. Identification. Thanks, sir.
Those heading for the Gacy arraignment were searched not once, but twice. Here at the criminal court building entrance, and again outside the fourth floor courtroom where John Gacy faced Judge Richard Fitzgerald. Gacy was outwardly calm, neat, and well-dressed, a striking contrast to the haggard, forlorn figure the world saw being transferred between jails 3 weeks ago. This was Gacy the way his friends and neighbors had seen him, as respectable young businessman, not admitted mass murderer. In a courtroom filled mainly with reporters and police officers, Gacy's lawyer, Sam Amirati, asked that the charges be dropped because of pre-indictment publicity, that Sheriff Elrod and medical examiner Stein be held in contempt because of news leaks, and that the digging at Gacy's home be halted. Judge Fitzgerald, ordering Gacy held without bond, passed those demands on to the judge he's assigned to handle the case, Louis B. Garippo, a 10-year criminal court veteran, former first assistant to state's attorney John Stamos, and member of the politically active 36th Ward family. Garippo's father, Louis Sr., is a ward committeeman and associate criminal court clerk. On the bench here at 26th Street, Judge Garippo consistently carries an extremely heavy caseload, but with relatively few spectacular cases, he has managed to maintain a low profile. Today's assignment will undoubtedly change things. Jay Levine, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
There's other court action tonight. Michael Antonelli, a reputed mobster, convicted for his part in the bombing of a suburban Lions tavern in 1975. Antonelli has numerous other charges against him pending in both state and federal courts. Terry?
Joel, in another courtroom, 16-year-old Jerry Kavinsky is sentenced tonight to 40 years in prison for the murder of 11-year-old Roger Myers. Kavinsky received a concurrent 20-year sentence for aggravated kidnapping. Reportedly, Kavinsky and four other teenagers were burglarizing the Myers home in Westmont last March when they found young Roger hiding under a bed, hugging a teddy bear. The other four have not yet been tried. The victim's decomposed body was found in a Willow Springs Forest Preserve last March. Kavinsky was convicted December 1st. Tonight, the state fire marshal's office is investigating the cause of an explosion that ripped through the Dalton Village garage. Firemen from five neighboring South Suburban departments battled the extra alarm blaze since 3 o'clock, but were unable to save the town's fleet of maintenance vehicles. Damage is estimated at $2 million. Two Dalton mechanics were injured.
Where there's fire, there's smoke. Big controversy, a new one on cigarette smoking, coming to a boil tomorrow. We'll have that story and others right after this.
All over America, Amoco is working to make our country less dependent on foreign oil. Here in North Dakota, where drilling had once tapered off, Amoco helped open up a significant new oil field. Amoco helped drill over 1,700 wells in America last year. That's important to American workers because the increase in oil imports in the last year alone cost America thousands of jobs. Every Amoco success makes American jobs more secure.
The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine?
For 1979, a beautiful new styling of Lincoln Versailles.
Best is yet to come.
The pride of owning a Lincoln distilled to a 110-inch wheelbase. The pleasure of driving in luxury. And now, each Versailles offers a choice of three roof designs. Until you experience the Lincoln Versailles, we think the best is yet to come.
Come the day you're mine.
This is Captain Rolock. Clinch your grenades for landing and prepare for a galaxy of cosmic values and low, low prices at Color Tile Supermarket.
At Color Tile, you'll save on a huge in-stock selection of tile, wallpaper, and paint. Get genuine pre-finished oak parquet tile from only 39 cents. Or save on stylish floor tile from only 13¾¢. Load up on tile, wallpaper, and paint at Color Tile's low prices.
Shop Color Tile now.
When
you prepare a main course, you want quality at an economical price. That's why Jewel's Grade A poultry is a smart choice. That Grade A assures you of poultry that's tender and rich in flavor. And through Saturday, during Jewel's poultry sale, you'll also be assured of economical prices. Like whole fryers, only 47 cents a pound. Then for dessert, top a home-baked creation with Golden Farm Stand bananas. Only 18 cents a pound through Saturday at Jewel's.